Just 30 tons in the haggard we'd got, of oats and barley and wheat. There was a slew out and a bit to cut. The harvest was rather late. Well, then, the Melliah was took today. It's a show, though the fun was them days gone. We worked that day till 3:30 instead of dinner from 12 to 1. We had started at 7 that morning bright. The women and girls was a treat to see, with their pretty washed prints on the stockings so tight. For myself, I was full of glee. With bright hoop sickles and oxter placed, and then rail our sunbonnets, bless their hearts. Along the dewy hedges, their way they traced. They defied for freshness the finest arts. Now then, says Jem, as the field we reach, that field was far Jem Max. Nan and me to the forig, you brats to teach, to follow behind in our tracks. Put pits on the gat, and if he can't keep up, let him go with the gals to make bands, and if he can't do that, let him help to stook, where he'll get a few thistles in his hands. And as true as I'm here, if he doesn't look out and work his sickle like a man, at the Melliah, he'll get the dirty get out. I don't care what he might say. Then up to Jem waddled spare pits, and he swung his sickle right round his head. He swore till it all flew out in spits. He'd any day work old Jem into bed. Keep ye cool, ye wind to cool ye porridge with, pits ye bark. You could do as Bill Boyd's bellows for such. It's a pity you'll not want to cool your jaw. Then tonight you wouldn't get too much. Then Jem made us back a little more bent. It was bent nearly plenty to start. The sickle made a gring and a grunt as it went through handfuls of corn like a bat. The ring of the sickle in the rustling corn was all you heard now far and wide, like close-lined infantry in the act of storm. They fell their thousands on every side. To name these warriors with crooked swords, 20 there were, sure 2, is more than time or paper affords. Besides, we've the Melliah in view.